4 months ago, we got our hands on ROG Zephyrus Duo 15 and the first impressions were positive. But technology is always evolving and with 2021 comes a fresh, Ryzen-smelling generation of hardware ready to annihilate the old and dusty Intel processors. It's high time the new AMD CPUs were joined by the NVIDIA RTX 3000 series graphics accelerators for laptops. If it ain't broken, don't fix it, as this phrase implies, this high-end dual-screen gaming laptop got a nice refresh without losing its classic Zephyrus chassis, courtesy of Asus. Intel Core i9-10980HK was a decent choice back then, but its architecture and power consumption made it hard to manage, especially when integrated in laptops such as Zephyrus series. It's 2021 and the new AMD Ryzen 5000 series is here, ready to show off its power, stronger and cooler. Cooler like literally cooler. So let's roll. Honestly, I was okay with the second edition as well, since this one is actually the second Zephyrus Duo 15 iteration, just like we had the Windows 98 SE. Naturally, it brings some small improvements, but exactly where it should. AMD Ryzen 9 5900HX. Yep, that's the first major upgrade. Now, I wouldn't say AAS Plus, the active aerodynamic system, didn't do its job regarding the aforementioned high-end Intel CPU. On the contrary, AAS is one of the smartest and most efficient cooling methods we ever encountered. The idea of having large fan grills both on top and on the bottom is not new. Acer Predator Helios 700 made use of that, but Asus came up with two key features in terms of ergonomics. The secondary 14.1 touchscreen ROG ScreenPad Plus can be raised up at an angle of 13 degrees. And ScreenPad Plus itself acts as a sound barrier, so the user doesn't have to endure the noise the fans make when they're entering their full speed, up to 5000 RPM. Alas, not even AAS Plus couldn't work wonders in the case of a throttling Intel. We ran some tests concerning performance and turbo modes. The results, a multi-core CPU, almost 90 watts TDP, is no match for AAS. And we mean it. As shown, the consecutive Cinebench R15 tests portray some serious toughness. Otherwise, the system would have cut off the processor, which actually doubled its power consumption once it reached 45 watts TDP. Again, the results are magnificent. Multi-CPU rendering, AMD makes it to the first place, and the new 5000 series dominate both multi-core and gaming grounds. In the toughest situations, in AC Valhalla for example, the CPU simply won't exceed 80 degrees Celsius with 70-75 on average, completely acceptable given the performance. The second major upgrade is the GPU. It's integrated graphics, so it doesn't really equal the desktop variant. But remember this key aspect. The new RTX 3080 laptop has a maximum of 115-130 watts power consumption, but it topped every single score we got when testing Asus ROG G703 GXR MSI GT76 laptops powered by a 200 watts TDP NVIDIA GeForce RTX 2080 laptop. Do the math, less noise, decent temperature. For example, the biggest threat this GPU had to face was the ray tracing trial, but the CPU kept running under 80 degrees Celsius. Since we're discussing 3D Mark, this is the first time we've ever went past 11,000 points in TimeSpy for a laptop. During all those tests, the two fans almost reached their limit, 4700-4800 RPM. But the noise never went past 46-48 decibels. Turbo mode doesn't offer any jaw-dropping overclock, but every single megahertz counts, as shown here. Naturally, with turbo comes more RPM, higher noises, but compared to those 50 decibels laptops from 2019-2020, I'd say 46-48 is pretty decent without using headphones. The third major upgrade is the display. In terms of main screen, ROG Zephyrus Duo 15 SE offers two variants. The gaming one, retaining the same ultra-fast display of its predecessor with Full HD, 300Hz, sRGB 100%, 3ms GTG, and the hybrid one. And here's the biggest change. Instead of the classic 4K UHD IPS 60Hz 100% Adobe RGB display, designed for video and photo editing, Asus went for a brand new model crafted by AU Optronics. This is why it's perfect for both gamers and editors looking for high color accuracy. Therefore, the screen offers high quality colors, extended gamut, Adobe RGB 100%, 93% DCI-P3, and 96% NTSC, in combination with a fluid 120Hz refresh rate at 3 milliseconds, suitable for gaming as well. Aside from the two speakers on the bottom side, the laptop now has two tweeters. Connectivity has been gifted the latest upgrade, trading the old Type-A USB 3.2 Gen 1 ports for the faster USB 3.2 Gen 2, with speeds up from 5 GB per second to 10. And it's nice knowing that some of these ports can also be found on the back of the laptop. There's also a microSD card reader for the video and photo editors out there. The laptop sports a great battery of 90 watt-hours, but the 4K display quickly drained it in just 5 hours, without even touching the secondary display. If you powered up the latter and see it at 30% brightness, the main screen was set at 100 nits for both tests, the battery died after 3.5 hours. There you have it, folks, a rather hungry screen pad. Content creators can rejoice, for their favorite laptop just got some welcome upgrades. Zephyrus Duo 15 SE is probably one of the most complete and complex models of the Zephyrus series, even if some of its things will probably be frowned upon, like the lowered keyboard, the tiny touchpad crammed into the right side of the keyboard, the absence of a rest pad. As of wrist rest, they should have aimed for other material. I mean, the soft rubber collects every single grain of dust, but still, it's nice having something comfortable for your wrists. Even the two screens could have been better if it wasn't for that thick frame. On top of that, I would have been much better if the ROG ScreenPad Plus had offered wider angles, so we can lift it more and achieve that natural fluidity when working with multi-screen. Zephyrus Duo 15 SE redeems itself with its high-quality construction consisting of aluminum and magnesium alloy. A solid build, the laptop is pretty heavy, 2.4 kilos, but that can be easily neglected. And a premium keyboard, which is a blessing for your fingertips. Thanks for watching, and if you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to our plucky channel. Cheers!